Hello. Last video we discussed how to express the concentration of the solution, where we discussed volume percentage, mass by volume percentage and molarity. In this video we will discuss normality in detail. Before going to that, we will recap molarity. Molarity is defined as the number of moles of solute in 1 liter of the solution. Mathematically it is written as N by V in liters. 1 m solution means 1 mole of solute is taken in 1 liter. That is, we call it as 1 molar solution or simply molar solution. Decimolar solution means 1 by 10 mole of solute is taken in 1 liter. That is 0.1 mole of solute in 1 liter will give decimolar solution, and it is represented as 0.1 m. Centimolar solution is 1 by 100 mole of solute is taken in 1 liter. Otherwise, 0.01 mole of solute is taken in 1 liter. That is what we call it a centimolar solution. It is represented as 0.01 m. Normality, it is usually denoted by the letter capital N. It is a very important term. We used to have this term in volumetric analysis. It is defined as the number of gram equivalents of solute in per liter volume of the solution. So mathematically it is written as number of gram equivalents of solute divided by volume of the solution in liters. It is written gram equivalents is abbreviated as EQ. So we can write in the mathematical form, normality is equal to EQ divided by volume of the solution in liters. So here when you see, EQ represents the gram equivalents, capital E represents the equivalent mass, M0 represents the molar mass or molecular mass or molecular weight. Now, normality is equal to EQ divided by volume of the solution in liters. But EQ, the gram equivalents, can be found out by using weight of the solute and the equivalent weight of the solute. So when you divide the weight of the solute by equivalent weight of the solute, we will get the gram equivalents. So equivalent weight of the solute you will get by dividing the molecular mass or molar mass by N factor or equivalent factor. So equivalent factor is the term given in your book. So you divide molar mass, molecular mass by N factor, you will get the equivalent weight. When you divide weight divided by equivalent weight, you will be getting gram equivalents. So when you write normality, normality is equal to the equivalent weight you replace with weight divided by equivalent weight. So you will be getting weight divided by equivalent weight into volume in liters. Now the equivalent weight you can replace with this, that is molar mass by N factor. Then you will get W, that is weight of the solute into N factor divided by M0 into volume in liters, because you are replacing E by M0 by N factor. N factor goes up. So you will be getting weight of the solute into N factor divided by molecular mass M0 into volume in liters. How to calculate N factor or equivalent factor? So for acid, bases, oxidizing agents, etc., we can calculate N factor. First we will take acid. So in acid, the number of H plus ion or the basicity given by 1 mole of the acid gives N factor. That is number of H plus ion. For example, hydrochloric acid you take, it in aqueous medium it decomposes to form H plus ion and Cl minus ion. So only one H plus ion is formed. So its N factor is 1. H2SO4 decomposes to form 2H plus ion plus SO4 2 minus ion. Since we have formed 2H plus ion, its N factor is 2. So in acid, the number of H plus ion, otherwise called as basicity, will give the N factor. Now base, the number of OH minus ion or acidity given by 1 mole of the base will give the N factor. For example, sodium hydroxide, if you take, it decomposes to form Na plus ion plus OH minus ion. Only 1 OH minus ion, so N factor is 1. Calcium hydroxide, CaOH twice will give Ca2 plus ion plus 2 OH minus ion. Since 2 OH minus ion is formed, its N factor is 2. We'll see some examples. So equivalent weight is equal to molar mass by n factor, you know. For example, you take sulfuric acid. Sulfuric acid, first find out molecular weight. So hydrogen, 2 hydrogen, so 2 into 1. Sulfur, atomic weight 32. Oxygen, for 1 oxygen 16, 4 oxygen 64. So and the atomic weights of all elements, you will get the molar mass divided by n factor. N factor for sulfuric acid 2. So that will be equal to 98 by 2, that is equal to 49. 49 is the equivalent weight of sulfuric acid. Similarly, for sodium hydroxide, I add the atomic weight, 23 for sodium, oxygen 16, hydrogen 1. So when you add, you will be getting molar mass, and the n factor for sodium hydroxide is 1. So you divide by 1. So 40 by 1, that is equal to 40. 40 is the equivalent weight of sodium hydroxide. The next, for salt. For salt, the n factor will be given by the number of positive or negative charges. Only the magnitude of the positive or negative charge will give the n factor. For example, you take sodium chloride. You can write Na charge is plus 1, Cl charge minus 1. So only the magnitude 1 alone you take as a n factor. Calcium chloride, calcium 2 plus. For 1 chlorine, minus 1. For 2 chlorine, minus 2. So only the magnitude 2 alone can be taken as n factor. Aluminium sulfate, Al to SO4 thrice. For 1 aluminium plus 3. For 2 aluminium plus 6. For sulfate, 1 sulfate minus 2. 3 sulfate. So minus 6. So only the magnitude 6 alone can be taken as the n factor. So you take some example. For sodium chloride, when you find the equivalent weight, sodium 23, for chlorine 35.5. When you add, you will be getting 58.5. But n factor is 1. So you will get 58.5 as the equivalent weight of sodium chloride. For calcium chloride, for calcium 40, chlorine, 1 chlorine 35.5, for 2 chlorines multiply by 2. So divided by n factor, n factor for calcium chloride is 2. So you divide by 2, you will be getting 111 divided by 2, 55.5 is the equivalent weight of calcium chloride. For oxidizing agent and reducing agent, you have to see the change in oxidation state per molecule, or the number of electrons lost or gained per molecule will give the n factor. So you take a potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate is a very good oxidizing agent. So in different medium, it will give different product. So in acid medium, it gives an Mn2+. So the oxidation state of manganese you calculate here. For potassium plus 1, for 1 oxygen minus 2, for 4 oxygen minus A. So manganese will get plus 7. Because you have to add all the oxidation state, that will be equal to 0. So plus 7 is the oxidation state of manganese here. Here, my Mn2+, so plus 2 is the oxidation state. So plus 7, plus 2, the change in oxidation state is 5. So only the 5 electrons are involved in this reaction. So the N factor for this acid medium is 5. If you take potassium permanganate in basic medium, it will be converted to K2MnO4. So find out the oxidation state of Mn here. For potassium, 1 potassium plus 1. For 2 potassium plus 2. For oxygen, minus 8. So totally that will be equal to 0. So plus 2 minus 8. Here you should have plus 6. Only then it will be equal to 0. So manganese plus 6 oxidation state. So the change in oxidation state is 1. So only 1 electron is involved. So its n factor is 1. For neutral medium, potassium permanganate is converted to MnO2. So Mn oxidation state is plus 4, because oxygen, 1 oxygen minus 2, for 2 oxygen minus 4. So total will be equal to 0. So manganese will have plus 4 oxidation state. Here plus 7, here plus 4. The change in oxidation state is 3. Only 3 electrons are involved. So 3 is the n factor for potassium permanganate in neutral medium. So you take here, for potassium permanganate, you have to see the medium. Only for, after that, you have to calculate the equivalent weight. So for acid medium, if you take potassium permanganate in acid medium, so E is equal to molar mass by N factor. Molar mass, add the atomic weight of each element. For potassium, 39. For manganese, 55. For 1 oxygen, 16, 4 oxygen 64, add, you will be getting 158 divided by n factor. N factor is 5, so 5, when you divide you will be getting 31.6. so 31.6 is the equivalent weight of potassium permanganate in acid medium. In basic medium, 158 divided by 1, because basic medium n factor is 1, so 158. In neutral medium, the n factor is 3, so 158 by 3, that is equal to 52.66. Then relationship between normality and molarity. So normality is equal to weight of the solute into n factor divided by molecular weight into volume of the solution in liter. Molarity is equal to weight of the solute divided by molecular weight into volume of the solution in liters. When you compare normality and molarity, you can see here m and W divided by M0 into V, that is present here, W divided by M0 into V. So you can replace this with the help of M, molarity. So you can write normality is equal to, this you can write it as M into N factor. So normality is equal to molarity into N factor. So if you know normality, you can calculate molarity, or if you know molarity, you can calculate normality using N factor. Another one is, relation is, you write for normality, gram, number of gram equivalents divided by volume of the solution in liters. Then molarity, number of moles divided by volume of the solution in liters into n factor. So volume cancel. So you will cancel out volume. You can write number of gram equivalents is equal to number of moles into the n factor. So number of gram equivalents is equal to number of moles into n factor. Gram equivalents, equivalents both are same. So when you have equivalents, when it is expressed in gram, it is called as gram equivalents. So number of gram equivalents or equivalents is equal to number of moles into n factor. Then another one relationship you can derive. So when you divide normality by molarity, then you can write for normality, you take this formula, that is weight of the solute divided by equivalent weight of the solute into volume of the solution in liter whole divided by molarity, W weight of the solute divided by molecular weight of the solute into volume of the solution in liters. So volume, volume cancel, weight, weight cancel. You will be getting 1 by E divided by 1 by M0. So M0 you take it to the numerator. So molecular weight divided by equivalent weight. So normality by molarity is equal to molecular weight by equivalent weight. You can also use this formula for doing problems. One problem we will discuss. So this is given in the example problem. 3.15 gram of oxalic acid dihydrate is dissolved in water and the solution was made up to 100 ml using standard flask. Calculate the strength of the solution in normality. So molecular formula for oxalic acid is COOH2 dot 2H2O. So you write the formula, n is equal to weight of the solute into n factor divided by molecular weight of the solute into volume of the solution in liter. So you have to find out what is n factor. So n factor, since it is an acid, oxalic acid containing two replaceable hydrogen atoms, the n factor is 2. So now you can substitute. Weight of the solute is 3.15. Another one thing is, it is given volume in liter, but in the problem it is given 100 ml. Milliliter. So you convert into milliliter. So 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. So VML is equal to VML into 1 by 1000 liter. So you substitute here. Instead of volume in liters, you substitute. So VML divided by 1000, you will get the 1000 goes up. So you will have this formula. Now you substitute. Weight of the solute 3.15. Here it is given. N factor 2. 1000 divided by molecular weight is, you have to add the atomic weight of all the elements. For carbon, 2 carbon, so 2 into 12. Oxygen, totally 4 oxygen, so 4 into 16. Hydrogen, 2, so 2. Into dihydrate, so 2 water molecule. Dihydrate means, di means 2, hydrate is water, water, so 2 water molecules. So 2 into water molecular weight, 80. So when you add, you will be getting 126. So you substitute 126 into volume in ml, that is 100 ml. It is given. So you simplify, multiply these two, you will be getting 6.3, and then cancelling out these two, 10 divided by 126. So 63 divided by 126, that is equal to 0.5. Another one method is there. You can use, instead of writing this one molecular weight and n factor, you can write equivalent weight. So weight of the solute divided by equivalent weight into volume of the solution in liters. Directly you can substitute after finding out the equivalent weight of the oxalic acid dihydrate. So weight of the solute here also V liters convert into V ml, multiply the numerator by 1000. So you substitute W is equal to 3.15 into 1000 divided by equivalent weight is here, since its n factor is 2, you divide the molecular weight by n factor 2, you will be getting 63. So 126 is the molecular weight, dividing by the n factor 2, you will get 63. 63 is the equivalent weight of oxalic acid dihydrate. You substitute into 100. So when you simplify, you will be getting 31.5 divided by 63, that is equal to 0.5. So here also you can have one normal, deci normal, centi normal solution. One normal solution means 1 gram equivalent of a solute in 1 liter. So that is, we call it as one normal solution, represented as 1 N, or normal solution. Deci normal solution means 1/10 gram equivalents, or 0.1 gram equivalent of a solute in 1 liter. If you take, you will be getting deci normal solution represented as 0.1 N. Centinormal solution is 1/100 or 0.01 gram equivalent of a solute in 1 liter. If you take, you will be getting centinormal solution. That is represented as 0.01 N. So now we'll take example and discuss. So you take sodium hydroxide whose molar mass is equal to 40. When you add the atomic weight of each element, you will get molecular mass as 40. Equivalent mass is equal to 40 divided by its n factor. N factor for sodium hydroxide, only 1 OH, so 1, so 40. Now you can write, if you want to prepare one normal solution, then you have to take 40 gram in 1 liter. That means 40 is the weight of the solute divided by equivalent weight is 40 into volume of the solution is 1. You will get one normal solution. So 40 grams in 1 liter if you take, you will get one normal solution. 4 gram in 1 liter if you take, then 4 is the weight of the solute divided by mol equivalent weight is 40 into volume of the solution is 1 liter. Then you will get 1/10, that is 0.1 normal solution. That is deci normal solution. 0.4 gram in 1 liter if you take, then normality will be 0.4 weight of the solute divided by 40 equivalent weight into volume of the solution 1 liter. So you will be getting 0.01 N, that is centinormal solution. If you want to prepare one normal solution, take 40 gram in 1 liter. If you want to prepare decinormal or 0.1 normal solution, 4 gram in 1 liter. If you want to prepare centinormal solution or 0.01 N solution, then you take 0.4 gram in 1 liter. So next video we will discuss formality parts per million. Thank you for watching.